Hello and welcome back to Divinity, Original Sin. Last time we keel-hauled Pontius Pirate, great name, and killed the rest of the undead pirates down in the Black Cove. We're hunting around trying to find the final resting place of Nearly Headless Nick, or Actually Headless Nick, or just the head of Nick. Anyway, we've got some digging around to do, so let's get right in there.
Well, I think we were in the process of going down here and poor Ratin had died by poison.
Careful, comrade.
Go away, Muley. Heaven's sake, Muley. I'll take my leave. Go away. We were also trying to figure out what this trap did.
Yeah. That's, Careful. I think it probably did something with the... Hang on. Maybe. You just moved both boxes.
Yeah, sure. No, whoa!
I think it's a good plan.
There's an explosive mine there.
I know. So, watch this.
I do not think this is a good idea.
I think this is a brilliant plan.
Well, I'm far enough away that I don't care that much.
Yeah, look at me! it's still on it, so it still counts.
Let's not move it anymore, okay?
Come here, rat.
Rat. No, that's a trap.
Oh, rat! Goddamn rat! There we go. Not Jahan. Goddamn this rat.
Oh, it is a little bastard, isn't it?
I don't think it can actually be spoken to, this one. And that trap is just in the
Okay, right. Just right-click on it.
Yeah, and it brings up a little menu, and clicking talk doesn't actually talk to it.
Oh, maybe it's a rat destined to die, then.
It's entirely possible.
Seems legit.
Now, do you want a quick save just quickly? Because I want to try something. Because right-clicking on the mine has a use option.
Better to detonate that mine safely than trip over it myself. Better to detonate that mine safely than trip over it myself.
What, to just get his opinion on it?
There we go. That's safe.
Quote, quote, safe.
I know.
Oh, actually, combine with... I've got an empty thing here. Empty grenade combined with oil barrel. Damn. I thought that might actually do something.
All over the floor as well, so let's just in case.
Careful, comrade.
Go away, Muley. Piss off.
This oil is everywhere. So there might be a combat down here.
Yes, I see.
With pirate boomers.
Yes, I see that as well.
Anyone standing in a dangerous place? Jason Momoa is. Well, he's also put the rain on already, so I could use a fire arrow and just, you know, make this easier.
Go on then. I'll just skip my turn and save all my action points.
The only person that got hit was Medora. That's a couple of books that I've found so far. Let's have a quick look at what they are. So, The Adventurer's Field Guide, Volume 7 and 8. I'll just read that. And read
Why
that.
Are there so many traps around?
Send it to Maddie. To be fair, if I had a secret cove like this, I would fill it with
crud.
Traps. Hang on, I've got a thing for this. There we go. Totally doctored you.
Fuck's sake.
You just did exactly the same thing.
They come and they go.
I see. Alright, well, I'll do that one on there.
Look out, a I see a trap nearby.
Back off. Oh, it's all right. It didn't blow up. I'm gonna move the oil barrel though, just in case. Yep, that's fine.
My immense telekinesis is amazing for this.
It is pretty good when you use it.
Well, yes, I could use that one, but...
That went surprisingly well. Ooh, Secrets of the Scroll, Volume 8. Medium poison resistance potion might have been useful earlier.
Yeah, might have.
Let's read this Secrets of the Scroll. Mm-hmm. Very interesting. Send that to Medora.
Can you send me the teleportation pyramid?
Are you going to throw it over?
I am. Oh, you could throw it over.
I'll... try and throw it over myself, I guess. Now, how... good. Just to, like, there.
No!
Isn't that where you wanted it?
No!
It's far enough out the poison.
It's... Right, okay, I see where you've done it. Yeah, no, you totally missed the whole point of me talking.
You wanted it on the thing.
No, fine.
That way. Oh, sorry. See, I had my screen down here with the pirate chest. All right, well, that is pretty immense.
Right, send to Siscario, send to Siscario. Basically, all of this is stuff for you. And yes, that was hilarious. Oh, gosh. Ah!
Hang on.
No, it's fine.
Because I don't want you appearing in the poison and blowing yourself up even further.
I wouldn't mind that, actually. That would be kind of funny. Oh, an eye. A potato.
A stitch in time,
there you go.
Are you gonna just giving it back to me? Oh, damn it. Do you want to grab it? Because I didn't pick it up. Well, I clicked on it.
It's now saying can't reach. Let me just get a little bit closer. Oh, fine. We're going to do it the hard way because you messed this up.
Now, this is valuable.
Right.
Totally worked. Ooh, charming arrowhead. I'm going to make that into a charming arrow right now.
Oh, it's such a charming arrow. Oh, there's Headless Nick.
Aha, right. Let me just craft up this arrows. Ooh, I don't actually have a... All right. Combined with... Where's the arrow shaft? There. Yay, got a charming arrow.
I'm going to talk with Nick. Are you just making up loads of arrows?
I'm just making up some because I've got some arrowheads. So I figured, why the hell not?
The body stirs. The subtle slouch in its decayed shoulders suggests intense.
That's not the right way to do that.
A large, Chunk of flesh falls to the ship's floor with a melancholic thud.
I really like this narrator's voice. It's sultry.
Hold on, I'll be over in just a moment. Ooh, there's a portal here.
Right, I've stolen Nick's diary. But by stolen, I mean...
So this is what's to become of me, it seems to moan. A body with no head. A ship with no captain.
That is a little bit sultry, but...
Dejectedly, it proffers a hand.
Knowing that it's Nick.
Is this isn't Nick. I've already bought his book.
You accept it, taking it by its spine with
if I had known he was just going to give it to me, you can give me my two coins back.
Are most valiant.
So, about your head.
Grows cold, then hot. After all this time, reunited, could it be real? Could it be true? Tremors overtake its hands, its knees, and then...
And then what? He explodes in a shower of cum all over the deck.
Legs, arms, fingers. A bit more rotten than when I last saw them. But who am I to...
Hey, it's Nick. He's only level 3. You can totally take him.
Oh, the feeling of air in my minimally perforated lungs. Well, not quite.
Lovely ooze pumping through my only moderately decayed veins.
Moderately decayed veins. What a joy it is, my friend. What an absolute joy. Now for my last unfinished business. Pontius Pirate, the animal who consigned me to the masses. I won't rest until his skull cracks beneath my foot.
We could go and fetch his skull.
Dead? Dead and dead for good? Never to rise again?
Well, how certain can we be about things like this?
Yeah, I mean, I know a necromancer, right?
Well, I would have loved to see him collapse to dust myself. But your assurance is most satisfactory.
It better be. I mean, we've carried him all this way.
With my head back on my shoulders and my foes defeated, I owe you a large debt of gratitude.
Of gold. Of gold. He said
that wrong. I'll take the ship, honestly. Look at these silky sails. That looks well nice.
That does look like Vanta black sails.
To you, then. Your enemies from now and forevermore shall be as my own. Call me when you will, where you will, and
we're going to get a scroll of summon Nick.
What if we have a falling out amongst our party?
Well, then obviously I've been carrying his head.
Fine, you take the head, I'll take the body.
I'm dying to try out my right hook, now that I've got arms again after all. Until we meet again, Source Hunter, I remain your humble bodyguard, eager for your summons.
Interesting.
It was Source that drove Pontius mad, yet it is Source that has kept Nick alive to fight his old foe.
Hmm. I don't know.
Though we are sworn to eliminate it, there is more to Source than simple evil.
Despite any silver linings, Source is a dark storm that threatens destruction wherever it goes.
Renegades!
What? Again, I still don't even know what that does to me. Right.
Oh, I am even on Renegade and Righteous.
Ah, so I'm now Righteous One.
So you're now the leader, I suppose.
No, I am now Righteous Renegade equal, actually.
Oh, same here. So.
Oh, well.
Never mind. See, I thought... It does fit more with my character, but I must have done something good beforehand. It doesn't sound like me at all. So and yet we are still no closer to finding out who committed the murder.
Yeah, so this is the derelict harbour. Should we go back to Black Cove?
I think that sounds like a plan.
Because we never did find what's through that giant door, which I think is just down here. I could be wrong. It could be a long way down here.
Well, just down here is a very ambiguous term.
Yeah, down there. So I see a pillow. I see a torch. I see you giving me the teleportation stone.
So, oh, Hang on.
Also, I do have a Summon Nick skill book.
Do you have a Summon Nick skill book?
Slash.
Why give you the teleportation stone when I can just do this? Oh, path blocked. Too high.
Oh, I've got telekinesis better than yours, so maybe that works for me. Well. Too steep. Path blocked. I can't throw that far.
Because there is actually that door. Maybe we can get through the door.
Right. Let me just put this Summon Nick skill on my thing.
I've just opened it with the key that we found.
Oh, well, that solves that.
And you know what that means?
What, you're getting the loot first?
Totally stole the pillow.
Oh gosh, it looks like there's a dragon.
What? A dragon corpse, maybe?
Well, yes, the state of the dragon is not up for discussion.
All right, let's talk to the cat, the rat. Crabs aren't that bad, at least they're not poisonous. That doesn't bode well.
A dead dragon? Who could have bested one of Rivelin's most ancient creatures?
I bet we could have, with enough safe scumming. Is the rat leading us into under the waterfall?
No.
Rat. Come back here. Cave spiders can be rather crabby if you disturb them, so there's cave spiders as well.
Oh, another dragon.
There's also ghosts down there to the left. Desdemona is down to the left.
Did you hear what Urthel had to say?
Yes. See, I reckon we could take out two dragons as well with enough saves coming. I like how you quick save him. There's another corpse.
Yeah.
Oh, go away, Jahan. I'm trying to talk to the rat.
Nothing to say about this one.
Oh.
Oh, okay. Crap.
I could have warned you about that. My great-great-grandrat used to tell me about a great redstone that made the local fauna fierce enough to take on these dragons. It's drawing water from the sea. I'm really tempted to just leave you and go. What do we think? Poison and set it on fire, or just set it on fire?
I think it's probably immune to poison. Just guessing.
But poison creates explosions.
Yes, it does. Also, surprisingly, not immune to poison.
I'm quite surprised as well. It's a source nightmare.
Yes. That's why I said, oh crap, as it sort of fell down slowly on top of us.
I hope you've got water resistance on your stuff, and I hope that Maddie isn't actually hurt, because Maddie looks hurt.
Yeah, Maddie is a little hurt.
Are you summoning Nick?
I am.
You think he's going to fight this thing for us?
Sure. This is our enemy, Nick.
We've come too far to lose to such foes.
So, Medora.
That's a good critical hit.
Not enough action points to do another one, unfortunately.
I like to think that I've done pretty significantly by setting it on fire and poisoning it, but that was pretty cool.
Oh
yeah. Man, they do not like Jason Momoa. All right, well, let's not let it act again.
Great, because it was on fire before, so it's not going to freeze.
That's a very good point. Well, This is probably a good idea.
Works every time.
Works every time, but it didn't work.
What do you think, Source Hunter? Shall I start shredding from the top or the bottom?
Oh, you control him.
Yes. So I've got two choices. I can either punch them or I can rip my foot off and throw it as a grenade.
What the hell? Foot grenade. That Source Nightmare is not having a good day. Did it just pee all over?
No, I think it was more like sick.
Okay, well, you know, whatever. Let's go raise power stance. And then I think we will try a ricochet. That was awesome.
So I think I'm just going to hit it lots.
Yeah, it's the only thing left. We should be able to take it out before it gets to act again. Ooh. Hey, there's Sam's collar.
Hey.
Got it.
Sea spider's claw. Definitely taking that.
That's a very nice looking thing.
Right, I don't think it's as nice as the things that I'm currently using, but you know, yeah, it's a dagger. Oh, sorry, Nick.
Plus one to sneaking. I mean, I prefer my plus one to speed and initiative, but I'm going to send these to Earthel just in case they're of any use to you. And likewise, just in case.
Just doing some impromptu healing. Okay, let's look over this gear that you've sent over. So those sneaking boots are better. Yeah, I don't have immunity to slowed from them, but I think the air resistance is probably better than plus one boss ring, so I'll wear those.
Yeah.
Hat of Life is quite nice. Yeah, I'll wear that as well. Push Dagger of Expertise. No, I don't have enough dexterity for that. Armor also not quite good, and the robe is also not quite good.
I'll send you a cleaver as well. Just in case. Oh, damn it, I sent you a wand. Would you mind sending that back?
To Jahan?
No, to me, because I need to ID it. Thanks.
Yeah, I could use that cleaver instead of, instead of clobbering time. Oh. Yes. Oh, at least the knockdown chance. I do really like
it's,
the knockdown.
It's a tough call, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm going to send you something to Earthel. It's an amulet. Might be for you or might be for Maddie.
Oh, interesting. I'll give that to Maddie, I think. Send to Medora. She can wear it instead of the claw amulet.
I'll send Maddie the keys as well that I've got. Just to organise my inventory a bit better and make sure I don't accidentally sell them. Right, which means I should send that to Jason Momoa because that can go in the food bag.
Oh, Desdemona. Wasn't that the lighthouse person's
interest? Yeah, I thought something like that. There we go, that'll do it. Right, I'm coming over.
Your flesh. Why, you're positively radiating.
And listen in.
Years since a warm blood has wandered through these caverns. An utterly lovely sight.
Positively radiating.
She has a small amount of money and a stardust herb.
Oh, probably worth taking the stardust.
I'm just selling her some plates. Oh gosh, that's way too much. Let's take the gold cups back. 75, that's better. Empty bottles.
Yeah, you need to really manage the amount that you give them for what they give you.
Crab's claws. Might be able to use those for something. Let's just balance that. 85 left.
Despite just traveling through time and space, money management is still an issue we face.
Yes. I'm going to sell her the inert stones. Yeah. Oh, arrow shafts. Send those over to you. Balance.
Ooh, definitely. Right, well.
He could never. You mean to say he left us to those savage waters on purpose? I can't believe it.
Well, that's what he said. He did.
And yet, if what you say is true, well, I must meet him in any case. To the lighthouse, you said? Fine.
Oh, fine. You're just going to teleport there.
Well, I guess we go back to a portal. Oh. Stand back. Yep, yeah, why not? I'm just going to ID this and see what it is. It's not that good. And he's got a lot of armor. I'll send it through to Earthel and you can decide whether to have it on you or Maddie. Wait, what the hell is that? A tremor grenade. Cool.
Oh yeah, I'll send that over to you. I thought that might be a nice surprise.
Yeah, I will always take a tremor grenade. Now I wonder, is there anything else that we can potentially dig up around here? Did Nick die?
Nah, he's fine.
Pontius, his mad cackles jangle in
fine, whatever. I don't mind having several Nick corpses following us around. Doesn't look like there's anything really over here.
He doesn't last very long.
Although, given that the rat was talking about a red stone that made the...
I think that's the one that we took from wherever it was.
Ah, yeah, that would make sense, actually. All right. I'm on my way. Actually, you know what?
Although I am curious how that spider managed to take out... Source Nightmare managed to take out two dragons when we had no problem dispatching it.
To be fair, it's probably been a while since there was an actual combat, and it may have had more than just it helping out. Yeah, we're running all the way back. We could just use that little teleport thing on the side, couldn't we? Is it the Sicile Harbour? Or secluded beach, probably.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Must gather your party before venturing forth.
Because you closed the bloody door. Right, here we go. Some people.
Yeah.
Okay, now we can have a look at the... Nope, that's not... Map is M.
Right, so we can go speak to the lighthouse person, or we can go speak to Sam. Those are our two next most important things.
I think let's do the lighthouse, because I'm kind of curious. So that'll be the desolated farms.
Yes. Yes, it will.
And it's raining over here.
Still quite a long way to run, though.
Oh, yeah. I moved my screen all the way over there, clicked on the location, and now I'm watching my people run.
Are you trying to slow me down with lightning?
Maybe. I don't know. Oh, there's a rat I can talk to.
Not only that, did you not notice the... people fleeing.
I did. I saw them running right over.
They seem to...
They run off...
Yeah. I think they jumped off the edge.
That's pretty extreme.
That is very extreme.
I mean, I'd run away from us as well, but...
Did they say they were going to kill themselves last time we spoke to them? I can't remember.
All right. The conversation has started down here.
Oh, I'm coming.
I know, Amos. It's so romantic.
Okay, I'm listening in. Desdemona, my love, blada, blada, blada. Constant, blada, madness, depths.
And yet, look at us now. Not even death could impede our reunion. I beg of you, my love, forgive me.
He's got some inert stones, some plates. It's almost like someone traded with him already.
That lunacy left there. Forgive me, my wife, my own. Forgive me.
If she gets angry and tries to kill him, I'm going to be so annoyed that we didn't do it earlier.
You've heard the whole story by now. Perhaps you can help me.
Desdemona is under no obligation to forgive her murderer, no matter how sorry he may be.
Why perpetuate anger and rage? Desdemona should forgive the sorry soul.
If you're so forgiving, I should be able to throw you against ocean rocks and expect a hug afterwards, yes?
Do you really want two haunted, hostile souls wandering Sicily when there could be two peaceful ones?
That's not good. This is not good.
My first victory. Reason wins out.
All right, we'll do it your way.
I suppose you're right. The deed is done.
It's that easy to get someone to forgive you. I mean, just playing rock, paper, scissors while two people argue nearby.
I do forgive you.
Hey there, RJ. Good to have you join us. It's been a very long day. I'm very much enjoying all of the games this evening so far.
Even the diamond hides its dull complexion.
I'm going to talk to the rats.
The nightmare is at an end.
No, not you, Jason Momoa. Go away.
And shall remain so evermore.
Yes, the past is the past, my darling.
And instantly I regret the fact that I have just enabled an abuser to continue abusing his mistress in the afterlife.
You very much have done that. Fools if they think they'll find happiness now. That's the kind of thing my person would do. Betrayal awaits. As well as encouraging murder.
Come on, grumps. The dire is all there. They'll kick off their ghostly boots and have a nice time of eternity.
Yeah, today I've had a 6.5 hour long meeting.
Whoa, that's fun.
And Alex has got jury duty, so yeah, we're both pretty shattered.
Yes. It is nothing I can talk about, but it is long, long and intense. Have you headed back to town?
Yes.
Ah, you went to the North Gate as well.
Yeah.
Ha-ha!
To go and speak to Sam, and then I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, there we go.
Let's go give him his collar. Past the dead sheep. I'm sort of learning my way around Sicile now.
Yeah, navigating by the landmarks that we create rather than their own.
All right, I'll talk to him.
Can I talk to him?
Meow.
Meow.
About Maxine.
Whiskers, you found my collar? Oh, thank you. Bless you. I shall don it right this instant and hie me to Maxine as fast as my paws can carry me. You have made me the happiest cat in the world. Indeed you have.
He's going to get some pouring action. I'm going to follow him. Not because I'm that curious, but I'm that curious.
Yes, you're quite right, RJ. We could head off to the pub, but to be honest, I like the routine of Monday night games. And I've got a couple of beers here anyway.
The collar I told you about. The one you told me was but the fancy of a dream. Here it is.
a band of jewels such as no one in.
Please tell me you can hear this as well.
Yes, can.
Dear me, that choker looks absolutely fabulous on you.
Is this the announcer slash narrator?
It's real. Oh, darling Sam, you are a Tom of Means after all.
That I am, my little tigress. Behold my true color.
The voice acting in this is very, very well done. Dedicated to your happiness.
The cats, oh, marry?
What a passionate puss you
what
are,
questions judge, this game prompts?
Sam, as virtuous as ever. But indeed you do seem to have the right and reason to be.
Of course, he does.
I shall hold you in suspense no longer. Yes, my dear Sam, I will marry you.
She says as she talks directly away from him.
Yeah. Beating anew with untold vigor. Well, notice that she's partly presenting her rump as well, so.
To you.
Lady. Fire of the hearth, let us lie and purr the night away.
Oh.
And so Sam's story has a happy end after all.
It wouldn't have if we had never found that collar. Maxine only agreed to marry him because he is rich now.
Oh, see, my reaction, IRL, is yes, she's a gold digger.
What a cynical thing to say. She loved him all along, but was worried about the children they might have. That's quite another matter.
It is a pity indeed to see how this treasure of a cat, this pinnacle of nature's beauty, has been corrupted by the wretched moors of man.
Face materialism has darkened the purity of her soul and seized the I really like Jason Momoa.
Has seized the very throne where love should rest. Let the story of Sam and his beloved serve as an example of this bitter truth. Between two humans, no love is unconditional. So strongly does this sad depravity seep from our every pore that it adulterates the innocence of what should be stainless spirits.
I'm guessing he hasn't been laid in a
while. Stainless steel spirits?
From the inability to bestow love devoid of logic, devotion devoid of design. Wealth, status, prestige, the carnality of flesh and fortune. Those are the true motivators of the affections between a woman and a man. Love. It is the name we give a base ambition, a delusion we blindly compel to be true and therefore falsely hold to be absolute. Pity love, and be wary of her too, for she is but a deception.
Man, he is bitter.
Yeah, I agree.
What nonsense! Only those who have never truly loved deny the existence of true love. Why, I have this fancy potion that I smelt earlier today, and now I love everything!
Nonsense, is it? At least one of you has realized that love is but the vagary of fantasies, the intemperance of puerile minds. I shall not deny that my mind too was puerile. I too loved a woman with all my soul, believing her to be. Ah, enough. Forget what I said. Dig love a grave, and there let it rot.
We're not going back to the graveyard.
Amazing. You know, I wonder, all of those other people that we have the option of hiring in the Hall of Heroes, do they have amazing dialogue and voice acting as well?
I really hope so.
Fresh heaven. Perfect for
fire. Right, I'm gonna have a chat with the fish vendor.
Not in the mood for cheese.
Ooh, actually, hang on. So about that fish thief.
You were talking to that would-be thief. Thank you for preserving my stock. It's no wonder you saw.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that was.
I forgot we did that.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I've also sold her a ton of paintings. But is there anything else I could sell her in the meantime for more money? A couple of plates, a light gold cup. Yeah, I'll clear out some of this stuff. A pot, a pillow. Broken bottle.
Yeah, I should do the same. Oh yeah, that's point. This is the marks person, so if you want to buy skills, then this is a place to do it. There's
a
very nice bow here as well. Let's see. Sell aside the bloodlust. I'm just going to sell lots and lots of things.
In fact, I could sell most of the equipment to the fish vendor just for money.
Oh, I've got a pickaxe now as well, by the way.
Oh, cool. For hacking through walls and stuff.
Well, I was thinking for mining. You know, we keep finding things that we can't mine.
Yeah. Let's do the... No, that'll do. So, balance that. Man, I've got 12,000 gold now.
12,000? Yeah, that's a bit crazy. Yes. Oh, I've gone way over what she can afford. Give me some of these things back.
Let's see. Halibut, sheep's cheese, tomatoes.
Sounds like one of the villagers is going to cook up a storm tonight. Let's halibut, sheep's cheese, tomatoes. She keeps repeating it. Tomatoes.
Oh, exactly the right amount.
If we kill the chicken, will they mind?
I don't know. Ooh, that's a very nice ring. Yes, I am going to buy that. No, I'm not. I think you should buy that. Have a look in the Fletcher. She's got a legendary ring.
Oh, there's a very... Oh, that bow is worse than my current one.
Yeah.
Which is a shame. You said a very nice... Ooh, what? The locksmith's dull gold ring of the serpent?
Yes.
My rings give me perception. I mean, it's good, but I've not been going down lockpicking. I'm more interested in those charming arrowheads.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
Did you send me those arrow shafts that you found?
Yes,
two
I
of
did.
Them? Yes, yeah. So if I get both of those...
How gratifying.
That's good,
return.
Though. You are the leather armor with fire resistance and initiative and immunity to poison. That's like my current one, but... Well, actually, no, it's slightly worse than my current one. It's still good, though. Hmm. Does she have any just plain arrows? Oh, she does up the top. Okay, so let's buy the freezing arrows. In fact, let's buy all the arrows, because I'm not going to spend the money on anything else. I'll have a look at the skill books as well in a moment. Right, so, absorb the elements skill book. Oh, that's just water resistance, etc. up. Farseer. Improves chance to hit with ranged weapons over long distance. That's not bad. 2 AP cost for better chance to hit. Ricochet, I already know. Ranged power stance, I already know. Ranged precision stance. Reduces movement speed chance to hit up. Oh, okay. Splintered arrow, I already know. Survivor's karma. 100% chance to set lucky for 5 turns and karma for 5 turns. Oh, so that's good for looting stuff.
Yeah,
probably
I suppose.
Probably good at the start of the game, but... first aid, I already know. Treat poisoning is an actual skill. Well, I'll get treat poisoning. I may as well get absorb the elements. Let's get Farseer, let's get ranged precision stance, and I'll get...
It's also a very nice wand over here on Selenia, part of the Legion. I'll read it to you. Plus 1 speed, plus 29 hit points. Allows you to cast Immolation. Number of uses, 3.
Most wands have got a skill that it allows you to cast. So it's alright, but it's not spectacular.
Dexterity and intelligence ring.
That's potentially interesting. I'm going to buy all the arrowheads as well while I'm here. I'm still only spending like 4,000, 5,000.
I'm looking for better weapons myself.
Okay, ooh. So what can I give you in exchange for these? You can have that. I don't think I'm actually going to end up spending any money.
Well, you're just stealing.
No, I'm selling all the crap that I'm carrying. Nah, I'm gonna spend some money, but it's not much. We could also go to the blacksmith's place, and I can make some bits and bobs, I suspect. All right, let's even that out. So I am spending 1,935 to get all the skill books I wanted and all the arrows. I consider that a pretty good deal. Let's go into my crafting. Okay, so recipes. Don't care about weapons for the moment. Let's have a look at... I can make a fuse with rope. I don't really want to do that. Let's make two charming arrows.
Oh, what now?
We'll make another knockdown arrow. We'll make four explosive arrows. Two poison arrows. And five steam cloud arrows. I'm going to start using these more frequently, I think. I mean, they are very good. It's just I've always been a little apprehensive because of the potential of running out of them. All right, I'm going to head up to the blacksmiths and see what I can potentially make up there. Let's resort this. And I will ID that crossbow that I forgot to ID from before. That's not bad. It's not special. It's not bad. Now, can I learn any of these skills? Let's learn Farseer, I think. Yep, learn Farseer. And let's learn Survivor's Karma.
Yeah, I think at the moment I can't learn anything. I think I'm maxed out on my skills.
And maybe ranged precision stance or absorb the elements. Absorb the elements would probably be useful for... No. I think I am maxed out on these. Yeah, I'm maxed out at the moment, but I got the ones that I was most interested in. So let's put them on my hotbar for now. So, Farseer. That comes down here instead of the poison thing. And Survivor's Karma. It's pretty cool. 105% chance to set Lucky for 5 turns, and 105% chance to set Karma for 5 turns. Oh, and I can cast it on anyone. Or is it just a... Ah, it's a group thing.
Oh, nice.
That's really good. It's important to test these skills before you get into combat and need them. Likewise, I can cast Farseer on anyone. But normally that'd be on myself. So Farseer, sight plus 5, chance to hit plus 50%. That is pretty monumental.
That is quite far. That certainly is quite far.
Come on now, I'm going to head up round to the blacksmiths very quickly.
Yep, I'll come over as well, actually. In case you can make something useful for me.
Alright, so what are the recipes? So I can make custom axes, custom daggers, custom swords. So let's combine that with... In fact, let's smelt up the ore that I've got, because I'm sure I had some ore. Maybe I put it on Jason Momoa.
Oh, maybe I should have given you things to melt down rather than selling them.
Oh, no. I'm not that fussed. All right, send to Ciscario. Combine with this. Silver bar. And another iron bar. So we've got 3 iron bars, we've got 6 steel bars, and 2 silver bars. Ooh, silver arrowheads come from silver bars, apparently.
I can make you some more arrow shafts if you want.
No, I've got 8 left at the moment, and I've run out of things that I can make, I think. Are those the only... I could do custom... Why not? Let's make a custom dagger. That looks kind of cool. How do I make a large bar? Probably a bar in a bar. Ooh, an iron bar into the forge makes a steel bar. That's interesting. What does a steel bar into the forge do? Nothing. Silver bar into the forge? Does nothing. I see a steel bar there. There's lots of improvements I could potentially make to armor, but I don't think I can actually make armor yet. Or at least I haven't learned how to do it.
Do we know if there's an oven anywhere?
Well, this forge that I'm right next to will probably count the furnace.
No. Needs an oven.
No, there's a washing tub here. I did not mean to pick that up. Let's put that down again.
Suppose it could maybe be downstairs in the pub. Let's go there. Actually, I remember. A cook's got a place. Almost certainly going to be one in here.
Yeah, so I've made a custom dagger, a custom axe, and a custom sword, but I don't think they're particularly special. I'm going to send them across to you so you can just have a look at them.
Cool. Let's have a look. The axe is all right. It would be nice if it had more ability on it.
Send the axe back. I'll see if I can improve it.
The dagger's no use because that's dexterity.
Yeah.
And what was the other thing you sent over? Custom sword. Yeah, again, that's quite nice. If it did anything at all, it would be better than it is. So sending that back as well.
Let's combine it with fire essence.
I'm just saving case this guy really doesn't like me using his oven.
That could work, but I need more crafting skill. So could that. So could that. Axe and sword does nothing.
No, he doesn't like it.
Okay, well let's use the axe on the whetstone and see if that actually gets any better. So the axe at the moment is 44 to 87. And the result, 49 to 98. So I've taken that up significantly.
Cool.
I wonder if I could do that again. No, but I could do the same with the sword. So let's do that, and I'll send both of those back. And then when I get a bit better at crafting, then they will become better just by the nature of me being awesome. All right. Send to you. And send to you.
Cool. Allow me to repay the favor. Have a couple of
rice. By sending me pig. Nom, nom, nom. That's pretty cool.
I'm totally thieving everything from the chef.
Of course. I mean, if there's any intestines there. Or sinew.
I shall keep my eyes open. How about hair?
No, just sinew, I think.
No, I found a holy hand grenade.
Interestingly, that's for healing, not destroying.
Well, I imagine it would work as destroying on undead.
Oh, possibly. I hadn't thought of that. I've got a couple. I made a bowstring!
There's a couple of pigs down here if you want to come and talk to them.
Yeah, actually, that's kind of interesting. Give me a moment. I'm just going to see if I can combine this crossbow with a bowstring. I don't think you could do crossbows with bowstrings, but 82 to 128. Yes, that worked. 89 to 139. I've upgraded my own equipment. I wonder, can I do that again with the strong sinew? No. But that was still pretty cool. Nice little crafting bit. Right, I'm going to come across to you. Let's sort this. Do you still have the pyramid?
Sent it back to you.
Oh, no, I've got it. There we go. You sent me the blue one instead of the red one. Let's have a talk with the pigs. She's singing it. That's very cool. And there's, of course, the rats down here as well.
Oh, I found a needle in a haystack. Well, did the rats have anything interesting to say?
I've talked to one of them. It just told us the archaeologist has lots of knowledge of the burial mounds. That'll be the guy that we rescued, I think. Never trust a doctor. They're all witches. Only a tiny bit of prejudice from the rats.
Ah, quartermaster might have something useful.
Well, source hunter, you come to the right place. You have. I got every style of equipment to fit.
Let's have a quick
foot.
Look at
if
the
it's
map
a trade
and
you're after.
See what.
Wow.
Potential. What have you
oh,
found?
Oh my goodness. Burning heavy copper amulet of storms. Plus 12% water resistance, unlock skill, fire absorption shield. Reflect 15% of any damage as air damage.
That's very cool. And at the moment, I've got a sub-zero fine copper amulet of the contortionist, which reflects 20% of melee damage as water damage. But yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, I don't think I want anything else that they've got.
I might take a gander just in case.
Yeah.
I see, yeah. Oh, that's a full skill. Mine just does it by default. Much like the heavy copper amulet of the heart. Water absorption scroll. Some star fishes, inert clawed wand, inert wooden wand. I'm assuming we could combine them with things.
Probably.
Come to see what well, you got your rat's tail, you got fuse. Some more arrowheads, empty canisters for grenades.
Sending this guy his own painting of the pig back.
Of course. I mean, why would you not? All right, I think I'm done with that.
Me too.
So I'm gonna step down. And actually, I think with that, it's probably a good point for us to finish that episode there. So thank you very much for watching. Do hope that you've enjoyed this run through the cove and finishing off of Sam's storyline and Desdemona and the lighthouse ghost. I forget his name. And of course, Headless Nick, who is now no longer headless and summonable.
Samson. Samson, that was his name.
Samson the ghost, of course. It's been good fun for us. If you are enjoying it, do remember to like the videos and subscribe to the channels to be notified when the next ones come out. But otherwise, we'll see you next time for more Divinity Original Sin.